Hey guys, welcome back to Baby Bump Life's podcast. This is Nurse Wit here, and we are on episode 2 of our first season. And today I want to talk to you guys about things to do while you're pregnant so that you can prepare for baby's arrival. Some of these things I think are a little obvious that most moms know to do these things, but some of them I see moms that come to the hospital in labor and I ask if they did these things and they're like, oh, I didn't know I was supposed to do that. So I've got a few tips here for you guys today. One of the first things that I think a lot of moms know to do is pack their hospital bag. And it's kind of up to you when you want to do that. After 30 weeks is probably a good idea to start thinking about it at least. Make a list and start getting a bag together for supplies there for you, baby, and for dad. Making sure that you have everything you need. I do have a video on my YouTube channel about what to pack in your hospital bag. So if you haven't already, make sure you definitely head over to YouTube, type in Baby Bump Life, and you can look up that video for what to pack in your hospital bag. Another thing that I think a lot of moms know to do is the baby registry. Of course, family and friends want to be there for you during this wonderful moment, and a lot of times they're not sure what to buy you. What do you need? So doing a baby registry, we actually did ours at Target and then we did at Amazon. Most of our family does live out of state, so we did a little virtual baby shower, which was fun, and they just sent Amazon packages to us, which was kind of fun. We would get packages all the time, and we just lined up all the boxes in our guest room and had our little virtual baby shower, and it was super cool. So doing a baby registry is a good idea and starting to think about things that you need for your little one. And plus, it's super fun, and I thought it was really fun for Dad and I to do because we got to like look at outfits. Oh my gosh, it's gonna be so cute to see him in this, or you know, what kind of bassinet do we want? So it was really a fun bonding time, I guess. Another thing that you wanna do is check out a hospital tour. So start talking to your doctor about what hospital they do deliver at and make sure that the hospital you pick is a hospital that your doctor has privileges at, because not all doctors go to all hospitals in your town. So, and then check out that hospital. Most hospitals do have tours where one of the staff members will walk you around, show you the labor and delivery department. They may answer any questions that you have, and it just helps you to feel more relaxed. So when you do come there in labor, you know where you are, you know the drill. So checking out and getting scheduled for a hospital tour. Another thing to do, and this is one thing that a lot of moms forget to do, is pick out a pediatrician. When you get to the hospital, we are going to ask you, who do you want for your pediatrician? Who's your pediatrician that you picked out? And a lot of times moms are like, I didn't know I was supposed to do that. It's okay if you don't, or if you would deliver early and didn't have time. There's always an on-call pediatrician who will see your baby at the hospital, but it's a good idea to just pick out your pediatrician. That way they can see baby from, you know, the moment that they're born and follow up with them afterwards. So definitely make sure that you take the time to pick one out. Call your insurance company, see who you can go to through your insurance. And then a lot of the times, the pediatricians will have prenatal appointments where you can go there and check out the office, check out the staff, and see if it works for you. I do know most of the pediatricians that I work with in the hospital, so for me, I kind of had an idea of who I wanted to go to, but I really wanted Dad to feel comfortable with the pediatrician and the office staff and him being able to ask questions as well. So we actually went to a couple, and we didn't end up going to the very first pediatrician because, well, both of us just didn't agree with some of the things being done there, and I don't know, just didn't have the right vibe. So we actually ended up going with our second choice, and it was nice. We just both felt comfortable. We knew it was the right choice for us. So anyways, picking out a pediatrician is important to do. The next thing I have here on my little list is right before you're getting ready to deliver, you know, maybe like 32, 34 weeks, 36, something like that, going to either Costco, Sam's Club, and stocking up on things. We knew that I was going to have a C-section. It was planned. And, you know, you can kind of check out my blog on the reasons why that we had to have a planned C-section. But we went to Costco and we stocked up on toilet paper, dish soap, laundry soap, paper towels, napkins, plates, all of that kind of stuff. So that while I was on maternity leave, we didn't have to worry about going out and purchasing any of that kind of stuff. So that was really nice. The other thing was we have an Amazon Prime membership, which was super nice too, because if we did forget anything, we could have that sent to the house either the next day or, you know, in a couple days. So that was really nice to have, you know, some supplies at the house just so we weren't super stressed out about, you know, the basics of the house and grocery shopping. And then one of the last things that you want to do, and I kind of touched on this just in my last episode about taking classes, but it is super important to get signed up for childbirth, baby basics, infant CPR, and also breastfeeding classes if you're planning on breastfeeding. And that's just so that you can feel prepared and you know what to expect while you're there. Too often I have moms who are just, you know, I'm telling them what the next step is going to be or what the doctor has ordered, and they're just staring at me like, I have no idea what you're talking about. And so it just really helps to be prepared, and that way you know what the nurses are talking to you about and the doctors are talking to you about in the hospital. So if you aren't able to get into a class, definitely check out my YouTube channel. I do have some free classes on there, some free videos on there that you can check out. And then here in the next couple of months, I'm going to be putting together some videos actually on my website so that it'll all be packaged a little bit nicer for you guys. So definitely look out for some classes coming up here at babybumplife.com. I want to get those all packaged up and just perfect for you guys. So I am going to work on that here, you know, in my quote unquote free time, whatever that is, as a mom and a night shift nurse and, you know, all of my daily things that I need to do. So anyways, I hope that helps you guys. And that's a little bit of a list of some things that I feel are important and some of the things that I did while pregnant and preparing for my son. So I will talk to you guys all very, very soon. And please always feel free, if you do have any questions about anything, email me at babybumplife@gmail.com. And I would love to answer any questions that you guys do have or point you in the right direction for any of those questions. So thank you guys all so much for listening, and I hope you all have a great day.